Good morning. I hope that you are all having a wonderful day, no matter what time it is where you're at. Today is another gentle yoga day. So all you will probably need is a blanket or two. Again, this can be done from a chair, and possibly next week I will get it figured out and I'll be able to do a chair yoga sequence with you. So we are going to go ahead and Mama really should put her glasses back on so she can see, but that's close enough. We are going to start in a comfortable seat. If you can, sit crisscross applesauce, as they say, and have your right leg in front. Take a moment and we'll take a couple of breaths in and out through our nose. You can close your eyes. Or just soften your gaze. Try to have a pause between the inhale and the exhale. So you will inhale, pause, and exhale. We are going to start with gentle stretches. So take your left hand and just place it on your right foot. Extend your right arm up and just reach and rotate that wrist. And you can gently lean towards the left as you do this, but not going too terribly far. And then we'll bring that arm down and gently place it on the foot and take the other arm up and do rotations with that wrist. Again, you can lean a little bit towards the right. You can look up at your hand, or you can even close your eyes. And we're going to reverse, this time taking the left hand to the right knee. That will cause you to twist a little bit more. Now remember, if you can't get that right knee, you can go right to that calf. And bring that arm down. And go to the other side. And come to center. From here, we are going to do shoulder rolls, and you're going to take your shoulders up, back, and down. Up, back, and down. And you may hear some snap, crackles, and pops, and it's quite all right. And now reverse, take them forward. So you go back, up, forward, and down. Couple of more. We're going to do some upper body rotations. So lean to the right, Come forward, back over to the left, and just really enjoy taking this nice slow movement. Do two more in this direction, and this will be our last. All right, switch which foot is in front, and we'll get that on the other side. Come up to center. We are going to go ahead and swing our legs to the side. Again, you may do this from a chair still. You do not have to get on your hands and knees. And you come up onto the blanket, let your knees hang off. And we're going to do a couple of cat cows. So you inhale, you look up. Drop your belly. Exhale, round like an angry cat. Inhale and exhale. One more. Let your knees hang off the front edge of your blanket. Now, if you have difficulty sitting this way on the floor, if you have a pillow or a blanket, you can roll it up and put it between your feet. If you have a block, you can maybe you can put that block between your feet and gently sit up on the block. If that block is not high enough, you can always add a blanket and just lay it across. Well, I say lay it across. I told you I keep it real. Take it and drop it across the back of your calves and then sit on it like this. All right. Take a moment. Hands together at your heart. And you inhale and you come up. Exhale, you sit back down. Now, if you're in a chair doing this, you're just sitting and you're gently coming up to standing. And as you sit back down, you lean forward as your knees bend, and then you come back down. So it's lean forward to come up, lean forward to come back down. I need to scoot back a little bit, and we'll do this again. And if you're in a chair, you don't have to come up very high. You can just act like you're coming up and then come right back down. All right. We're going to undo all this fun stuff that I've done. I am gonna keep the block because I am gonna use it to come up onto my feet. And again, I did not come prepared. I'm such a wonderful person. I really am. I think about these things and then I don't ever get them going. All right. And I know you can't see all of me. Let me see. Let's move her to the side and see you stepping back. Oh, you barely get me. That's all right. It's all good. All right, we're gonna take our legs wide. Inhale our arms out and gently fold forward and then come back up. Forward, you're only coming halfway and then back up. As you come forward, your hips and your bum go back and then you come up and you go back down. I'm gonna grab this block. This time I'm gonna hang out right here for just a moment. I'm going to walk my feet a little bit closer. Leave your hand, your left hand on the block. The chair would work wonderful, or a table. And just take your left arm or your whatever arm it is. I knew I shouldn't have tried to reverse it. And you're only going halfway. And you're just switching side to side. Keeping it nice and easy, we're going to bring ourselves back down to the floor. And we're going to, if you don't have a block, don't worry about it. If you do, place it between your feet and actively press the balls of your feet, the heel, into the block, activating different muscles. Nice and tall spine. Slowly and gently let your hands go down towards your feet. You're still nice and tall. You're not hunkering down. We're not rolling or rolling our spines forward. We're keeping our back nice and long, almost sitting upright, except you're just leaning like this. You're not rounding. And to come further into this, if you wish, you can bend the elbows. Again, keeping the shoulders back, not letting yourself crouch or scrunch your body forward. You're just hanging out here. You can massage your feet if you like. You just grab a hold of them and keep them warm. Let your head bow just a little. gaze should be down towards your toes. Take your hands and let them go back behind your back. All I'm doing is doing my hands just like this at my low back. Slowly and gently sit upright. If you had a block, remove it. Gently bring one foot in, followed by the other, sitting whichever way is comfortable for you. We will do some cat-cow seated. So I'm gonna turn just a little bit so you can possibly see maybe better what's going on with the body. You inhale, take the shoulders back. You're almost trying to make your shoulder blades kiss. Your chest opens. And then exhale, you round your back, creating a C, although my C has got fluff and it's all right. Inhale, shoulders back, chest is lifted. Exhale, round. Chin is tucked. Couple of more and just go at your own pace. Last one to round. Go ahead and we will come on to our belly the best way that you know how. Let your elbows be directly underneath your shoulders. I'll give you a few moments to get here. You can also do this on top of a bed. Now, for some of you, this may be already a great back bend, okay? You don't have to go any further than what you are right now. For those of us that might need more, we're going to press into our palms and lift our elbows up off the mat. Your gaze is down between your thumbs or your index fingers, maybe just a little bit out in front of it. If you'd like to go a little bit deeper, you can scoot your hands back just a little bit. Slowly and gently lower yourself down. take your arms out in front of you and cross them, and you're going to place your forehead on your forearm. Slowly and gently place your hands directly underneath your shoulders. Take your elbows and draw them in towards your body. Slowly just lift up your chest. Don't go any higher than your chest. Gently raise both hands up off the mat. And slowly come back down. Slowly and gently push with your hands, but sink back into child. So take wide knees. Your legs are as wide, making space for the fluff in the middle. If you don't like putting your head on the mat, you can get a blanket. Slowly and gently come back up. Bring one leg forward and come into a seated, comfortable position. Taking your time, letting your head and your neck be last. Take your right hand down to the floor and your left arm up and over, and then switch, taking this nice and slow, and you're just going to go side to side. The slow flow of bending in this way. And don't worry if you can't go as far as I go today. Tomorrow I may not go far at all. And as always, only do what feels good to you. Just think of me as a guide, making suggestions. All right, this is the last one. Come back to seated. Let your palms rest face up on your lap. Close your eyes, and we're going to do what I call a sighing breath. And as we do it, we're going to touch our thumb to our index finger, then our middle, then our ring, and then our pinky. And you'll just go back and forth, touching the tip of your fingers to your thumb. Okay? It's nothing major, it's just almost a tapping, if you will. When you tap yourself, the vibration, which we may do that on another day. But your sighing breath is an inhale through your nose, and then you open your mouth and sigh it out. And I will begin with the inhale. Keep your hands down on your lap. I only have them up to demonstrate. One more time. Slowly bring your hands together at your heart, letting your fingertips touch first, then gently pressing your palms together. Softly open your eyes if they were closed. Take 3 regular breaths here. The light in me honors the light in each of you. I hope that you have a wonderful rest of your day or evening. And until next time, peace out.